Hey guys, it's Jay Burnham, and this is another episode of the Real Jay Burnham Show. And I apologize for these videos coming out and later in the day lately, and that's only because I didn't want to be doing them in the hot sunshine. It's just so hot here. So I've been doing them late at night, when a little later at night when it's a little cooler. So please forgive me. But this video was actually inspired by one of our guys in the Moving Company Insiders Group, our secret and exclusive group that only a few people are into. But there was a guy named Eduardo who had a question for me, and he asked me yesterday. He texted me and goes, "Hey, I got this big complex, apartment complex, and they want me to do all these moves and give me a proposal. How should I do it? You know, how should I give them a discount? What should I say?" You know, and that was a very good question. So let me actually give you a little bit of story what actually happened to me. Last year, I got called by a apartment complex management company that needed to move out a bunch of people out of an apartment complex. Now, they had to move these people out of a car because it got condemned, because this management company had their heads up their ass and wouldn't fix the apartment, and there was a bunch of leaks. The roof was leaking, everything was broken and tore down. And I also need to mention that this is student housing for Michigan State University students. So this apartment got condemned by the fire department, and they needed to move everybody out of this complex very quickly. So I was one of two moving companies that they had called. Now, I've never done anything like this, and they wanted me to come in with, you know, and just move everybody out as quickly as we possibly could, which I was glad to do because I had crews available to do it. I told them my price. They said, "Yeah, let's do it." Now, when it came time to get paid, that became another story. And that should have been my first clue when I realized that this was the building that was being condemned, and it was all over the news that these guys were condemning, that I should have really put it in, had it in writing before we started any work. And we did a lot of work for them. We moved like about 15 apartments within like 2 days or 3 days. And it was really crazy. And these guys wanted to dick me around on my pay. They told me like three times one day, "Oh yeah, yeah, it'll be there today, it'll be there today." It wasn't there. Then they asked me, I asked them again, "Oh yeah, it's gonna be there, it's gonna be there." Finally, the last day, "Yeah, we've got the check ready, it's right here, it's just gotta be signed, it's available." So I sent somebody up there. And I'm a small independent moving company. It's not like I got, you know, tens of thousands of dollars in the bank like many of you. You probably only got like a few hundred, a few thousand maybe in the bank. You got payroll to handle. You know, you can't afford to have like $3,000-$4,000 just sitting out there not being collected on. That hurts. You got bills to pay. You got truck rentals and gas and all this other stuff, insurance to pay. You can't be doing it. Well, they wanted to dick me over. So I took to what I know best, social media, and I just made them look. But lo and behold, I got my check. So when you start making waves and you start calling up the news company about how they're not paying you, and they're already in the news, things happen really, really quickly. So that's my experience with it. Now, Eduardo might be having a little bit of different experience, and he did this quote, and he asked me a bunch of questions how he would do it. I personally, if you're going to be doing a large job, this is when you got to make your money. This is I wouldn't do a discount. I wouldn't necessarily give them discounts, but also if you have a 3-hour minimum, I wouldn't be worried about the 3-hour minimum. You're going to surpass the 3-hour minimum anyway. You know, you could give them an extra mover or two, but I really wouldn't worry about doing discounts. This is when you need to make your money. This is when you charge at full price, because if they need to move, they typically, if they're doing this kind of size move, they've got the cash, they've got the budget. It's also a company, so it's a little bit safer. Not always, like in my case, it wasn't. But they, you know, this management company, you know, they had the money, they just decided they want to be slumlords and, you know, not fix the property. But they do have the money. And, you know, I wouldn't do any discounts. Don't worry about discounts. What you need to do, though, is you need to be really super prepared and professional in your quoting. You got to prompt, you got to lay it out exactly what you're going to deliver, exactly when you're going to deliver it, how you're going to deliver it. Be very specific. Don't be worried so much about, you know, the benefits. Worry, concentrate on the features, because they're not concerned about benefits. They're concerned about what you're going to provide, right? So concentrate on the features, and worry about now. The best thing, if you can do it, get in front of the person who's actually going to write the checks or make the approvals. If it's a committee, try to talk to the committee. If it's just one person, try to talk to that one person. They can't necessarily do that, but you know, at the very least, get to somebody, that one person that you can contact with, like the manager or the general manager of the management company, so on and so forth. And really do and lay out specifically what you're going to do. Now, maybe I could convince Eduardo to give like a little bit of a, write a little bit of an how-to article of what he did with everything that he got, how he got the job, how he wrote out the estimate, maybe some copies. So Eduardo, if you're watching this, do that out, and then maybe we can give that out as a freebie. We'll have you sign up, maybe give us your email address for it, if he agrees to do that. I think that would be really cool, because a lot of you guys are like, how this might not be something that you run into a lot. And truthfully, it didn't happen to me until last year, and I've been, you know, 8-9 years in business. So, you know, it doesn't happen a lot, you know, unless you've really built up those communication lines and those relationships. So anyway, just don't worry about discounts. Just worry on concentrate on your features. Make sure you get everything in writing. So if they agree to use your services, get a contract in writing that they know exactly what you're going to deliver and what's expected of them, when they're going to pay you and how they're going to pay you. That's very important. Got to get that in writing. If you need to be paid on a Friday, that it's got to be in the contract that they're going to pay you on Friday at 10 a.m. or whatever it is that you decide. And they're going to pay by either cash or check or credit card if you take credit card. But however, it's got to be in writing and there should be no confusion, right? You got to really cover your butt on situations like this. All right. So if you guys got any questions on how to do large commercial moves like this or huge apartments, feel free to give me a contact. Leave me a message in the comments below. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Make sure you share this with all your family and friends. And of course, don't forget, subscribe to my channel. All right, guys, thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye-bye.